What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating another Intune policy. But today we are creating this policy to configure multiple display modes. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about configuring multiple display modes using Intune. If you have end users that have multiple displays, let's say, like for me, my 9-to-5 job, almost all the end users have dual monitors. So if I wanted to push out a policy to do extended mode, able to push that out and you're good to go. Or mirror mode is up to you. So doing it as an Intune policy in one shot rather than going into each individual machine and doing, you know, Windows P, which is the command to do the extend, mirror, and whatever, you're able to push out this cool policy. Now, to do this, the first thing that we need to do is log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. And on the left-hand side, we're going to click on Show All. We're going to locate the Microsoft Intune and click on it. So locate it and click on it. It's going to take you here. And on the left-hand side, we're going to go into Devices. So click on Devices. And within the Devices overview, underneath By Platform, we are going to click on Windows. As soon as you click on Windows, it's going to take you to the Windows Devices section. Underneath Manage Devices, we're going to click on Configuration. So go for it. Click on Configuration. We're going to click on Create, and that will give you a nice little submenu with two options. And the option that we are going to select would be New Policy. As soon as you click on New Policy, it's going to give you a side menu. We're going to click on the Platform dropdown, and we're going to select Windows 10 and later. For the profile type, we are going to click on the dropdown and select Settings Catalog. And at the very bottom, we're going to click on the Create button. And it is time for us to give our profile a name. I'm going to give it the following. BTNHD, configure multiple display modes. Pretty self-explanatory. And at the bottom, we are going to click on Next. It's time for us to configure it. So add settings, that is a hyperlink. So click on it. And as soon as you click on it, it's going to give you a side menu. So click on it. Here it goes. For the search, we are going to search the following. Multiple displayed mode. You are able to hit enter or click on the search button. And as soon as you do that, you're going to get only one option. So click on display. And at the very bottom, there goes our setting. Configure multiple displayed mode. So give it a check mark. Once you select configure multiple display mode, at the upper right hand side, we're going to click on the X to close the side menu. And it's time for us to configure our display mode. Now, by default, it is internal only, but to configure it, we are going to click on the dropdown, and there goes all of the options that we typically see when we hit Windows P. Now, for me, for my environment, again, we have almost all the end users have two monitors, so it's going to be extend mode. So that is what we are going to do. Extend. Might be a little different for your environment, so make sure you configure it properly within your environment. I can't tell you extend works for you. I can't, right? So once you pick your option, we're going to click on Next. For tags, Microsoft was nice enough to assign one for me, and it is called Default. I'm going to click Next here. For assignments, I am going to click on Add Groups, and I am going to select my group, and I'm going to click on Select. Let's click on Next, a nice little review, and we're going to click on Create, and on the upper right-hand side, it's going to say Policy Created. Created successfully, which is good. Refresh the page or give it some time. You will see your new policy, and that's it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.